Anyway, next presenter is Ahmed Hedeb. Of course, he is one of our best fellows, and now he is assistant consultant. And hopefully, very soon he will be a consultant with us here. Again, you can see, I mean, the main message really that it's not one person or two persons, it's the whole team within the interventional radiology who are really interested in this and to improve it.
I will present a couple of two cases, continue what Dr. Samir presented. We have a 75 years old female patient, known case of diabetes, referred to our service as a case of left organs. Critical ischemia presented with left big toe gangrene and wrist pain. On examination, strong bilateral femoral pulses, audible bilateral dorsal pedis, posterior tibial arteries by Doppler, gangrenous forefoot. On investigation, WBC is known as well, platelet and INR and GFR. As you see here, we have on the ABI and the PVR study, we have abnormal bilateral lower limb indices more in the left side, critically on the below the knee with abnormal waveforms below the knee at the leg and the ankle here. An ultrasound, the left atrium femoral artery Doppler showed a biphasic waveform, ours patent. The proximal SFA shows abnormal waveform with very sluggish flow around 22 centimeter per second, with further slowdown of the flow, with significant reconstitution of the flow at the distal SFA, as well as the popliteal artery. The posterior tibial and the anterior tibial arteries are patent with good waveforms. Then we proceeded with the with an angiogram starting from the right side with a retrograde femoral artery puncture, 5-French sheath, placing the catheter at the lower abdominal aorta. Angiogram was done, showed mildly abnormal bilateral common iliac arteries, and the flow was good, confirmed by the angulation of the tube. And if you see here, however, it's patent. Further down, we have a total occlusion of the left superficial femoral artery with, and as well as the right is patent with multiple stenotic segments. Further below, we have bilateral patent popliteal arteries. Posterior tibial and peroneal arteries are widely patent. The anterior tibial proximally are not visualized. Then, in the process of trying to cross the left total, the long occlusion, we tried from an antegrade fashion several attempts trying to cross, we couldn't. Finally, we tried to puncture the distal SFA from down in a retrograde fashion, and we went subintimally. Here we tried to join the two segments. With a small wire. And it was unfortunately unsuccessful. We went back, we used a special device to regain the track, called an outback device, and successfully was regained. And we snared the wire from the contralateral side. And the wire was pulled out from the right femoral artery sheath. Then we advanced a micro catheter and wire from above to try to link the whole SFA together. And it was successful. Then we came back with started with three long millimeter balloon throughout the SFA occlusion. This is the initial run post angioplasty. It showed the patent artery with the flow, but this is multiple non-flow limiting dissections. Then we decided at the end to stent the whole occlusion and still remaining the proximal dissection. Stented. This is a final run which showed brisk flow with. At the end, hemostasis achieved by angioseal closure device. Patient kept under our observation for 4 hours. Aspirin Plavix were prescribed for the patient before discharge. On her follow-up, patient significantly improved, rest pain improved, as well as the wound. We'll present another case. This is an 82 years old male patient, known case of diabetes, hypertension, ischemic heart disease, as well referred to our service as a case of left lower limb critical ischemia, presented left big toe gangrene. Strong on examination, strong bilateral pulses, audible dorsal hepatic artery by Doppler, dry gangrene of the left big toe. Investigation. WBC is normal, as well as the platelet and the coagulation profile and renal profile. Initial angiogram was done from the right common femoral artery in retrograde fashion, which showed patent bilateral common iliac arteries as well as the external and femoral arteries. Further down, patent bilateral superficial femoral arteries with mild stenotic segments, however, it's with brisk flow. Distally at the popliteal artery showed a reasonably long occlusion with single bilonear runoff to the anterior tibial artery. Posterior tibial and peroneal arteries are occluded. The occlusion was successfully crossed, and initially we started with a 4 millimeter balloon. Post-balloon dilatation, the left side showed the channel was open, but the flow started not brisk with multiple dissections. Went back again with 5 millimeter balloon. There is improvement of the flow, but still dissections are there. Then we decided to place a superior stent across the popliteal artery. This is the post-stenting. So the brisk flow throughout the occluded segment. Then we went down to improve the outflow vessel. The tibial peroneal trunk was dilated with a 3 millimeter balloon. The posterior tibia was successfully crossed and dilated with 2 millimeter balloon. This is a final with a patent popliteal posterior tibial with good flow to the foot. Again, post-procedure, we closed the puncture site with stark closure device. Patient usually kept in our department for 4 hours, and aspirin and Plavix were prescribed. Follow up in 3 months, and patient came with good brisk flow superior stent with ultrasound and clinically improved the wound as well. Thank you.